Hi guys, in this lecture we see physics paper number 16, energy studies and material science. This paper consists of two units. In first unit there are three chapters. First chapter is nothing but energy, wind energy. Second chapter solar energy, and third chapter is biomass energy. And unit second contains two chapters. First chapter is nothing but superconductivity, and second chapter is nanotechnology. But for this semester, only for you, due to COVID pandemic, the chapter superconductivity in unit second, chapter first, superconductivity is dropped for this examination only. Okay, therefore you have to study only unit first, all chapters, three chapters, and from unit second there is only one chapter, that is nanotechnology. Okay, now we see chapter unit first, from unit first chapter number first, that is energy and wind energy. Here first we see about energy. Energy is nothing but, that is capacity to do work. We know that is energy can be defined as it is capacity to do work. Okay? Energy exists in many forms. That are nothing but, that is chemical energy, nuclear energy, solar energy, mechanical energy, electrical energy, internal energy, energy from vegetables and animals, that is nothing but biomass energy, thermal energy, and so on. These are the different forms of energy. Okay? But according to principle of conservation of energy, total energy in the universe is constant. Energy in the universe is constant. The energy cannot be created or destroyed. It can be converted into another form. And this conversion process, energy can be converted one form into another form depending upon its yield. The conversion technology consists of three parts. Energy conversion technology consists of main three parts that are nothing but primary energy, that is which is also known as raw matter. First part is nothing but primary energy, which is known as raw matter. Second part, intermediate energy, and third part is nothing but secondary or usable energy. Primary energy, raw matter, it contains the resources of energy. It contains the resources of energy like, that is coal, colza, petroleum products, and wind present in the nature. See, aplyala raw matter nisargat milta, that is nothing but primary energy. That are nothing but resources of energy. Okay? And that are nothing but coal, petroleum products, wind energy present in the nature, or solar energy, and so on. These are nothing but first part of conversion technology, energy conversion technology, that is primary energy or raw matter. Second part, intermediate energy. This part, intermediate energy, can be obtained from primary energy resources by some processes. It is obtained from primary energy resources by some processes. For example, nuclear energy is obtained by fission reaction. Nuclear energy is obtained by fusion reaction. Okay, thorium kiwa kasha pasun, apan uranium pasun nuclear energy obtain karto. Mhanje thorium kiwa uranium ye kay jale primary energy resources jale, ani nuclear energy kay jali apli intermediate energy jali. Ani hi kontya technology na apan milavto, that is by using fusion reaction. Okay, then third part is nothing but usable energy, secondary, which is known as usable energy. This is a suitable form of energy for the consumer for final use. secondary or usable energy is the suitable form of energy for the consumer for final use. For example, the electrical energy supplied to the consumer is obtained from nuclear energy. Uranium, thorium, primary energy resources. For a conversion by fission reaction, we get nuclear energy. Nuclear energy can be converted into electrical energy. Therefore, electrical energy is the final part, that is secondary part or usable energy, secondary energy or usable energy, which is supplied to the consumer. Okay. Thus, the chain is primary energy, from which we get intermediate energy, and last part is nothing but secondary or usable energy. Okay. This intermediate energy can be divided into two parts. That is useful energy. This is directly used as a useful energy by the consumer. Therefore, this intermediate energy can be divided into two parts that are nothing but useful energy, which is also known as exergy. Useful energy is also known as exergy, and another part of this intermediate energy is nothing but worthless energy. And this worthless energy cannot be transformed into usable energy. Therefore, this worthless energy is known as energy. Worthless energy is known as energy. Useful energy is known as exergy. For that, the intermediate energy can be divided into two parts. That is useful energy and worthless energy. The worthless energy is the part of energy that cannot be transformed into useful energy or usable energy. This useful energy is known as exergy. The worthless energy is known as energy. Multiple choice valuta lakshaskara. Okay. Now, some natural energy matters are directly used for final consumption. Some natural energy matters are directly used for final consumption. That are nothing but that is coal can be used as a fuel. Coal can also happen directly fuel manu wapato. Firewood, lakwood can be used as fuel. Solar heat, which is used for cooking, water heating, etc. Some natural energy matters are directly used for final consumption. For example, coal can be used as fuel, firewood can be used as fuel, solar heat is used for cooking, water heating, and so on. Then we see next point, that is man and environment. Man and environment. Okay? That is the relation between man and environment. Man obtained or uses energy from the nature. Man obtained energy from nature in the form of raw energy, that is primary energy resources. Okay? The primary energy resources are processed and transformed to intermediate and finally usable energy forms. Okay? Energy conversion processes produces pollution problems. These primary energy resources can be transformed into intermediate and finally usable energy resources, which are used by the consumer. In this transformation technology or this energy conversion process produces pollution problems. Okay? A major part of energy is transformed to electrical form by power plants. Major part of energy is transformed into electrical form by power plants. Coal-fired power plants emit solid particles, SOx, NOx, CO, CO2, chemicals, etc. into environment, which pollutes the environment. Okay? Coal-fired power plants emit solid particles, SOx, sulfur dioxide, NOx, NO, NO2, CO, CO2, carbon dioxide, chemicals, etc. into the environment, which pollutes the environment. Then, pollution of environment disturbs ecological balance. This pollution disturbs ecological balance due to worse human population. Due to worse human population, the world's annual energy consumption rate is increasing at a rate of 2 to 4%. Okay, all the conversion processes emit solid, liquid, and gaseous particles. Gaseous pollution produces greenhouse effect and global warming. Gaseous pollution produces greenhouse effect and global warming. The relation between human life, energy conversion processes, and the environment is shown in figure below. Okay, this is the relation between the race, human life, energy conversion process, and environment is shown in the human life. आपल्याला लागणारी एनर्जी आपण निसर्गापासून घेतो. काय इन्व्हॉल्वमेंट पासून तुमची रॉ एनर्जी असेल, रॉ एनर्जी मॅटर दॅट इज कोल, विंड एनर्जी किंवा पेट्रोलियम प्रॉडक्ट्स घेतो जे कन्व्हर्ट करतो आपण इंटरमिजिएट ऑर सेकंडरी एनर्जी मध्ये. ओके, आणि ह्या कन्व्हर्शन प्रोसेस काय करते, डिफरंट पोल्युटन्स आर इमिटेड इन टू द इन्व्हॉल्वमेंट environment which pollutes the environment. Okay, therefore there is a disturbance in the human life. Environment is a disturbed. Okay, due to this there are different effects, that is greenhouse effect and global warming. Okay, this is about man and environment. Multiple choice of the characterizer lakshat characterizer. Then we see next point, that is some well-known forms of energy. Some well-known forms of energy. There are different energies we know. There is mechanical energy, electrical energy, chemical energy, nuclear energy, hydrogen energy are some important well-known forms of energy. Mechanical energy, electrical energy, chemical energy, nuclear energy, hydrogen energy are some important well-known forms of energy. Other forms of energy are classified into conventional and non-conventional. Parampari kind of parampari kuchas kopre. Okay. A parts energy forms upon Bhagwani are conventional, non-conventional. Shavdi agri achavati nimi swapno chakpa. Okay. Conventional, non-conventional. At first we see the some well-known form, that is mechanical energy, electrical energy, chemical energy, nuclear energy and hydrogen energy. First we see about, that is mechanical energy. Mechanical energy, the energy required for the movement of objects, the energy required for the movement of objects and change of their shape is called as mechanical energy. The energy required for movement of एक वर्ष दुसऱ्या ठिकाणी नेण्यासाठी जी एनर्जी लागते तिला मेकॅनिकल एनर्जी, किंवा तिचा शेप बदलण्यासाठी जी एनर्जी लागते दॅट इज नथिंग बट मेकॅनिकल एनर्जी. एनर्जी रिक्वायर्ड फॉर मुवमेंट ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट्स अँड चेंज ऑफ देअर शेप इज कॉल्ड एज मेकॅनिकल एनर्जी. सच टाइप ऑफ मुवमेंट इज रिक्वायर्ड इन ट्रान्सपोर्टेशन, हँडलिंग, प्रोसेसिंग, एग्रीकल्चर, इंडस्ट्री अँड सो ऑन. Such type of movement is required in transportation, handling, processing, agriculture, industry, and so on. Okay? Then, to change the state of motion of the body, to change the state of motion of the body, force is required. Force is required. Energy required to change the state of motion through a force is called as work. To change the state of motion of the body, force is required. And energy required to change the state of motion through a force is called as work. Thus, the energy in transit is called as work. Right? Energy in transit is called as work. Multiple choice la lakshat thevayche. Okay, then force equal to mass into acceleration, therefore its SI unit is newton, and work equal to force into displacement, therefore its SI unit is right newton meter or joule. Okay, ya thikani apan thambu. Pahile na